Hey yo, DragonMyth here, and welcome back, guys. We have something that's really, really cool. The new box art for Kingdom Hearts 3 just came out, I think a couple of days ago, if not maybe a week ago. So I'm here with another fan of the Kingdom Hearts series. He goes by the name of Ozzy. Introduce yourself, man.
Sup, my name's Ozzy. What up? Bonjour, people of Earth.
Okay, so looking at the box art right now, what can you speculate? I had a couple of my theories and it's been proven here. Like, for example, you have, not Naminé here, but you have my man here, oh, Roxas. I said that he's probably gonna, they're gonna find a way to bring him back since they brought him back. So they're gonna definitely bring Roxas
back.
Well,
it's obviously a thing now since, you know, the new trailer came out and literally showed him.
I haven't seen a new trailer. I'm going to have to watch those two. I'm just excited for that.
I cried, man.
Oh, I'm so excited. Another thing they're saying is something along with this lighthouse. If you go really close up here, it has something to do with Traverse Town. There's like a giant secret there.
It says something to do with Traverse Town, but I was kind of thinking more maybe like the world that never was or Daybreak Town, because Daybreak Town has a clock tower too, but it's like a different design.
Since they have the 12 darkness, let's count how many characters. So there's Mickey Mouse, that's one.
12 darkness.
Yeah, the 12 different darkness and 7 lights. So there's one, which is Mickey Mouse. There's Riku to,
Sora.
Sora's there. Why does she have her hair really, really short?
Well, that's her new hairdo. Or not Naminé. She's going back to the originals.
She is?
Yeah, remember, like, in Kingdom Hearts 1, her hair was, like, really short.
Yeah, I prefer the longer hair.
She's rocking the old do.
I prefer the longer one, to be honest.
She still looks good either way. Actually, yeah. She looks good with any kind of hairstyle, to be honest. So redheads, am I saying?
So, in characters total, so there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, no, there's more than 7 people, actually.
Yeah, counting Axel. Well.
Yeah. Well, technically, the original is 1, 2, 3, 4.
He's appeared in but we never really got any, Axel action with a Keyblade. Hopefully, we'll get that in the game, but, so far in the trailers, we have not seen any Axel action.
Yeah, but he did have his own Keyblade already in Dream Drop Distance.
Yeah, at the end of Dream Drop Distance, he got that badass-looking Keyblade, which, man, to be honest, I kind of feel like his Keyblade's kind of generic. Basically, it's just one of his chakrams with, like, a flame going on for the blade. But still, it's badass anyway.
It is badass. Okay, and then it looks like maybe he will be Unnorted. I forgot what his name is. I never really played as him. I did Aqua and,
Or maybe, like, the something to do with the Lingering Will.
Maybe. I only did Aqua and Ventus. I haven't done the third one. But it looks like he's going to be Unnorted.
That is a possibility. I've played all three, and to be honest, at the end of the... Sorry, this is probably going to spoil a lot if you haven't played the third one, but, like, at the end, he does get Norted.
Yeah, I know that. It also shows it in Aqua's and Ventus's playthrough as well.
Yeah. He gets Norted, and it kind of seems like there might be a possibility because of the Lingering Will. Because the Lingering Will is just his, like...
It's
will.
His armor. It's his armor, but with his memories and his soul. So if they can bring that back to his body, it's definitely doable.
That is actually a good point. Maybe if there was some way to get the armor onto the body, then the heart or the will of the heart and the memories will go back into the body and probably push out Xehanort's heart. Possibly.
Maybe. Okay, awesome. So now we're going to be going over the official TGS Big Hero 6 extended trailer. First, I want to do the Pirates of the Caribbean, because I haven't done that one yet. I'm excited for this one.
I'm excited for it, too. My God, I loved the freaking Port Royal world. I loved it.
Okay, are you ready?
Straight up. I'm ready for the feels.
Yo-ho, yo-ho, a pirate's life for me.
Oh my god! This is because of the Unreal Engine.
Because we get to be pirates again.
Yep, you always gamble like this world.
Still, it's a real shame we don't have a bigger ship.
Oh! That's from Dead Man's Chest. From Dead Man's Chest. That's the third movie of the Pirates of the Caribbean. So it takes place during that time and event?
Yeah, it does.
So it's after Jack Sparrow dies, and then he gets reincarnated.
Yeah, well, no, I think it it does take place in Dead Man's Chest, but I don't know if it's just starting right after Jack comes back from Davy Jones' locker.
Yeah, because that's the sandy scene where he goes from a giant sandpan to the ocean.
Yeah, but I'm not saying, like, in the game itself, like, when you get to the world
No. Yeah, I think when you play the game, you have to revive him. Like, that's what the
game... Yeah, like, you're going with Will, Elizabeth, Smee, Shaman Lady. You go with them on the journey to try to bring back Jack. Like that, you go through the whole process.
Okay, let's watch more. Let's watch more of it.
Yeah, you will be shocked. Look at that real-life facial. So beautiful. Just look at that.
Oh, yes!
You can drive a ship. You can shoot things. It is beautiful.
Oh, my God.
Oh, and about the Keyblade. That Keyblade right there, that new the new Pirates of the Caribbean Keyblade, there is a YouTube channel called Man at Arms that literally built a life-scale model of it.
Oh, my God. I'm so goddamn excited, man. This is so good. I'm so excited.
They're bringing back the Monkey Heartless. I love it.
Ooh, okay. Let's watch more. You can also go underwater?
You can go underwater now.
Oh, this is amazing.
Wow. Now in a synth egg. You can go underwater now in a synth egg. You're not a stupid mermaid in Atlantis. Wait,
okay, but look over here. They're bringing back the aspects from Kingdom Hearts 2, so it doesn't look like they're going to be doing the same thing with Dream Drop Distance. Or with,
there's, like, mechanics from Dream Drop Distance, like, flow motion and all that stuff.
No, not Dream Drop Distance. I mean, like, from, Birth by Sleep, where you have, like, multiple ones, and you just have to press, Triangle X to do the magical commands.
Oh, you mean,
commands.
Like, the limit commands?
I hate the limit commands. I hated that. It sucks.
I think it's called the limit commands.
It doesn't look like they're bringing that back. It just looks like they're bringing it back from, Dream Drop Distance and also, Kingdom Hearts 2. And you also have the max filter, so you know there's going to be multiple versions of Roxas. The Valor, Wisdom, and what was it? I forgot the third one.
Valor? That's what people have been saying, too. Like, drive forms coming back, you know, in a sense, like when you see, like, the Keyblade, when he goes through the transformations, like, with the Toy Story one, you go with, like, the hammer. So the hammer one, his attire goes red, like Valor form, right?
Yeah.
And then when you go to, like, the Rapunzel one, the Tangled, when he goes into, like, the little transformation when the Keyblade turns into a staff, his, like, clothes go blue. So people are saying, like, is it, like, a type of drive form or if it's like that? But Tetsuya Nomura said that it has nothing to do with drive forms, but then... To me, it kind of off and on with that. Like, he says it's not dry forms. It had nothing to do with it. But then, like, whenever, like, the third trailer, I think, when it showed him with his new, like, with the thing right now, when he goes to, like, the little staff with the Keyblade.
I think it's...
He's saying it's, like, something.
I think it's under... I think it's going to be under magic, where it uses your entire... Like, where you have special moves you do with Donald, like a triangle trigger buttons. Except for this one, it's like a trigger to change your weapon into, like, this awesome form. And it uses up all your MP. I think that's what he's talking about. Could be.
I guess it could, but, like, whenever it showed, like, him going through, like, the transformations, it didn't look like it was taking any MP at all. Like,
Did it take any of it? Oh, this isn't drive. This isn't the drive gate. It's called Focus.
Yeah, it's called Focus, and that's when you can, like, transform your Keyblade into, like, these forms, but, like, sorry,
Maybe it's going to be under...
It doesn't take...
Do they still have summoning, right? Whoa, dude, you're lagging.
Still summoning. Like, yeah, when you're in a Frozen trailer, you're going to be surprised at who gets summoned back again. You're going to be surprised. Okay. There's like one where you could actually summon air. It's pretty freaking awesome.
Okay, okay, let's watch it. Let's continue watching it.
Okay.
Ready?
Yep.
You bring back in the organization.
Riding on that rainbow. Luxord is back.
Isn't it? Jack, don't Norden, you give this creep the time of day.
Sora, stand down.
I always had a feeling like Luxord would be like something like Marluxia. He would like plot to go against the organization, something like that. I always felt like Luxord would be that kind of person, but, you know, Marluxia and all.
Get them! Sora!
You get to fight Titans.
They have come for us.
Oh, Toy Story 3!
No. Stop!
Farewell!
Yeah.
Arendelle is safer with me staying up here.
I don't really...
I can see the lip sync is coming back.
Please, go away!
The famous
Yeah, they're actually, I think there was like a little thing where someone asked like if the lips would match the English voices too whenever it comes out in America.
You're
because like there's an English version of this one that we're watching right now, and the lips literally match up to what they're saying.
I see. Okay, okay. They say like earlier there in this scene right here, she said that someone is one of the seven lice that they need. What does the organization have to do with any of this? I mean, sure that they want to have their bodies full, last time I remembered, but when we destroyed them and returned them to their original bodies, what use do they have with the seven lights?
Well, remember in Kingdom Hearts 1, the secret boss, that was Xemnas, or that was, he was wearing an organization hood, so obviously they had something to do with it before Maleficent even probably caught wind of any of it, because the organization was there the whole time.
Well, yeah, because it went from Kingdom Hearts 1 straight to Kingdom Hearts 2 after...
But no,
or not,
but
not,
Birth
not
by
I
Sleep.
Mean, in terms of the roles of the organization, the whole process of the games in between from Kingdom Hearts 1 to Kingdom Hearts 2, the whole games, that process from there to that end of the spectrum is the whole organization trying to get at Sora, trying to get his version to in order to kill Heartless in order to get their hearts. That's what the whole deal was.
Yeah, it does kind of sound like it, but somehow I feel like that's not the only thing. I think there was, like, a bigger purpose behind it all. Because, like, even in Birth by Sleep, whenever you're, like, when you're beginning the game, like, before anything, you see, like, Xehanort wearing one of the black hoods. So, obviously, the organization must have been, like, either gaining allies by that point and still going through with whatever plan. It all ends up in the Keyblade War, so obviously the organization might have been a part of, like, behind everything since the beginning.
Maybe,
like,
but they are, they were the good guys before. They were the people who were watching before the Key War.
To be honest, I don't really remember them ever being the good guy except for, like, the Master of Masters, but even he kind
of
sounded... He even kind of seemed suspicious in the whole Lushu thing.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe. Okay, let's continue watching it.
Yes, please, please.
Let's do this. Let's do this.
Larxene is big.
Now, set your heart free.
And at the end,
it's
kind of
going one frame per second for me, but it's still a good ass view.
In fact, your reward might be right around the corner.
Hey, Axel.
Huh?
Look how awesome Woody is now.
Cut your hair, too.
And the big reveal of KHIII.
Wow, she's grown. Man, ever since I've known her as a kid, she's grown up really well. So I wonder he's going to go undercover. That's why I want to know.
I don't know. Axel Lee, or whatever, whoever you call him, I'm just calling
I'm
him by whatever
Axel.
Names it.
I'm staying with Axel. Yeah, that's how I knew him.
Yeah, Axel kind of sounds cooler. But I do feel like Axel will be kind of like one of those undercover kind of characters. Like, you know, he's kind of like a backup character, but a backup character that will make a big difference in the end, you know? Because he's training with Kairi, you know, Keyblade and all.
You know what's
funny? It sucks, though, because right there,
What?
This kind of looks like the ending scene for the entire game. This right here.
Actually, I was about to say something about that, because Nomura said that where they are right now, you cannot go to. That's what he says. That's what, with the people, is asked, like, the area is like Twilight Town Woods, kind of like the backyard of Yinsen's tower, mm-hmm. or something like that. He says no, he didn't really, from what I've heard and what I've read, I can't really figure out if he gave any like hint of what this place is. Obviously, it's the training ground for new Keyblade wielders, but he says that what you're seeing now, you can't go to in the game.
Ah, I see.
Yeah. Okay. So it's like it's Castle in Kingdom Hearts 1. You can see it, but you can't go to it.
Oh, that sucks. Okay, let's continue. Oh, I'm excited.
Yo. Yeah, you're gonna freak. 3, 2, 1. Yep, the Recuplica has returned. But that's not the only Recuplica that returns.
True, but I think he accepted himself. That's just him in his past. Like in Dream Drop Distance, where
that could be the case, but like I have no idea though. But that's not the only time you're gonna see a Recuplica. You're gonna see a bigger one soon. Just watch.
Oh god. Okay, let's try not to talk during the cutscenes. I'll pause it every time if we need to talk about something, but ooh.
Okay.
This is gonna be hard. 3, 2, 1. Oh, I haven't seen this one before.
The feels are real.
Checkmate.
Look at that beautifulness.
The light is gathered to get a heart shift. Oh, Big Hero 6.
Like, did you see the look? Oh, look, Sora literally has a visor on. I love the way the Big Hero 6 Keyblade looks. I love it. It's just awesome.
What?
You can literally fly on Baymax.
Oh, this is amazing. And the world's a lot bigger. You can climb buildings. Buildings are higher. How big is the world?
I think they said that. Okay, pause it real quick. So, yeah. Did you see that one? Okay, so you saw what attacked Sora, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like the little blocks. What does that remind you of? The little design.
Wait, go back. I have to go back. Those?
Yeah, go back to like whenever Sora's fighting the blocks. Okay, that's a little forward. Yeah, right there. So just fight it, and then see, like pause whenever like it hits the blocks.
No, that's not it.
Wait. Yeah, that's like a new thing too. It's like bad.
Oh, those look like the thing from Sora's memory. Like digital form Sora. I didn't play the game.
The bug blocks.
Yeah.
The bug blocks. Yeah, those are what I'm talking about. They're apparently coming back, I guess. But like, yeah, you can fly on Baymax attacking the evil Baymax.
You know, I think this is going to be almost just as big as Final Fantasy XIV, except you have multiple worlds, but they're giant. So far, this looks like the biggest game ever.
I kind of had suspicions that it's probably going to be as... I know it's probably not, but I'm hoping that it is somewhat as big as the map in the new Spider-Man game.
I think it's going to be bigger, to be honest, than the Spider-Man game.
Bigger, I don't care, as long as it's beautiful and I can run around everywhere.
Yeah, yeah.
But, like, see, like, in the background, you can see, like, the evil Baymax from, like, one of the arts that you've seen. And, like, this is, like, a freaking minigame right there with parkour. Oh.
Wait, do they have a translation for English? I wonder if they do.
They should have English translation. They should. I mean, whenever I watched it, it was on my phone. But, it had English translations. Should.
Oh, yeah, there you go. I accidentally did Arabic. Nope. Okay, ready?
Arabic? Yep. Get ready to feel some feels. Just get ready.
Oh my god.
The feels!
I gotta go back. I gotta go back. I'm sorry, I gotta turn that off.
Minano Kokoro ni Yadotteru. Sono Kokoro no Tsunagari ga Hirotachi no Tsuyosa. Yami ni makeru ki ga shinai.
それはきっと、リクが大切な人を守る強さを手に入れたってことじゃないかな。
リク？
今、大丈夫ですか？
ねえ、見て！あれは何かしら？白くてふわふわしてる！
よう、ジャック・スパロー。迷子になったのか。
私はエルサを連れ戻したいの。
アナならきっと仲直りできるさ。
うん。
どうしてこんなところに。
こんな導く心のままに。
これが導いてくれるのか。
黒い箱の中身を見た者はいない。
お前らこそ13人揃ったのか。
もう揃ってるわよ。
俺たちもロクサスを探すの手伝うよ。
行ってみましょう。
もう一つのトワイライトタウンへ。
ああ、I wonder if you could change the look of Brox and Sora or whoever the main character is.
I have no idea. There was actually
I don't care if I have to pay extra, but if I get to buy, I get to buy items that change the how Sora looks or customize him, I'm a fucking buy it. I don't care.
I wanted to do that too. I'm pretty sure. I don't know for a fact. I don't think Nomura or anybody's confirmed it. I mean, if they did, I don't remember. But I hope they do bring the little mechanic where you can dress up like your character from 0.2. I do hope.
Yeah. Okay, okay, let's continue.
Or like, okay.
Okay, let's do this.
So,
なるほど。
キーブレード戦争の鍵を開く。
And then the reveal of Roxas!
No, I think that was Sora. That looked like Sora.
That was Roxas. That was Roxas.
Go back. I'm going back. I'm going back. That's the clock tower. That's clock. That's yes. Twilight Town.
I'm hoping this is like...
did you see that? Did you see that?
I am literally tearing up right now, man. I'm tearing up.
Oh my god! Sora's gonna save Aqua! Look! Right here! He saves Aqua!
Yes, I know! Basically, I think they're taking that right from the freaking 0.2 intro song. It is beautiful. I'm so happy that they're doing this.
Oh my god, I am so excited.
Tensou no kagi wo hiraku!
Okay.
Oh, it's Roxas!
Yes! Yes!
Roxas!
Wow! Oh my god.
Straight up Roxas.
Oh! Ah, my knee. Oh, I'm so excited.
I'm crying right now.
Is that the Oblivion?
I'm crying.
Is that the Oblivion? Or is that a new keyblade that he has?
I think that's the Oblivion. It looks like the Oblivion.
It looks so badass, man.
I mean, if it's a new keyblade, I swear it's like badass to a T. Top tier badassness.
Oh, I fucking
so
pre-ordered
close.
The game. I pre-ordered it too, man.
I wish I could high-five you right now because I pre-ordered it myself.
Hey, okay. Oh, that was amazing. That was absolutely amazing.
It was beautiful. So close, yet so far.
Oh, man. Okay, so it looks like this is going to be the final game of the trilogy. The final game.
I understand it will.
I'm kind of sad to see it go, but then again, they need to finish this. This has been going on for almost 12, 14 years.
I mean, I would understand perfectly if this was the last, but deep down inside, I'm also hoping it's not. True. I'm just hoping that this probably will come to an end of the Xehanort saga.
It is.
And then probably lead on. I know Kingdom Hearts 3 is going to be the end of the Xehanort saga. But from that on, I mean, I understand if it ends. I understand. And I will be very sad, but happy at the same time. But deep down inside, I'm hoping that somehow, some way, they'll find a way to probably, hopefully, maybe see if it can continue somehow.
You know what's funny? If they finish this saga and the next game that comes after it, he's all grown up, he's an adult, has a beard, everything, all these characters, they go back to the past, they go back inside of them, and then they all grow older.
It would be awesome to see them all grown up. It would, I mean, Sora with the beard, I really probably can't really see that. Maybe a shadow. Maybe, or maybe some scuffle, but I do not know.
I would like to take this time to thank two people for giving me this art that they've made themselves. As you can see, the two arts in the side and the two videos about to be shown, this is made by Kana and Crystal Dream Studios, all in their respected own works. Crystal Dream has her own YouTube channel. I really think you should check it out. She makes amazing art videos, and I think she's also doing art tutorials. And the other person, her name is Kana. She has her own Instagram. I believe she does her own art, and she posts it there as well. Oh, I almost forgot. Yeah, the song you're hearing right now in the background is actually made by a music YouTuber by the name of Grizz. He's really, really talented. I really think you should definitely check out his channel. He's also a really good friend of mine. I haven't contacted him here, and I did promise him I'd give him a shout out for making me this awesome, awesome sound, or song, I should say. Yeah, I've been really pushing in a while. I was waiting to get 500 subscribers to actually give him a shout out and use this thing. I would also like to thank you guys so much, so, so much for 500 subscribers. I wouldn't be here when I am doing what I'm doing if it wasn't for you guys. So thank you so much yet again. That's all I gotta say. See you guys later. DragonMyth, out. Oh, that's not so cringy.